गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सेंट क्लेरेट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। दिस इज नारायण, आई एम टीचिंग फॉर यू आईआईटी फाउंडेशन मैथमेटिक्स। सो इन माय प्रीवियस क्लास आई एक्सप्लेन अबाउट ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। वंस यू प्लीज रिमेंबर द कॉन्सेप्ट व्हाट आई सेड इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस। सो वंस यू रिकॉल ऑल द थिंग्स, ओके चिल्ड्रेन, सो वाट आई एम सेइंग एवरीथिंग नोट इट डाउन इन योर रनिंग नोटबुक एंड प्रैक्टिस इट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच अबाउट पॉलिनोमियल्स, ओके चिल्ड्रेन। सो पॉलिनोमियल इज वन ऑफ द सब टॉपिक ऑफ अलजेब्रा, ओके चिल्ड्रेन। सो अलजेब्रा, डू यू नो अलजेब्रा? अलजेब्रा इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विच डील्स अबाउट numbers and symbols, that is what x, px, x square, l into b, b square, a plus b whole square, a minus b whole square, like that, okay children. So algebra means what? Algebra is the branch of mathematics, okay, which study about numbers and symbols. In that algebra, one of the topic is polynomials. So before we are going to discuss about polynomials, first of all we know some fundamental concepts related to algebra. Okay, ready children, all of you please listen carefully and note it down on your running notebook. You can watch the video 2 or 3 times and observe it children. Okay children, understood? Okay, look at the board all of you. First definition, constant. What is a constant? Look at the board. A symbol having a fixed numerical value is called a constant. A symbol having a fixed numerical value is called a constant. What are the symbols? Look here, example 7, minus 2, root 3, pi, like that are called constants. That means if you take any quantity that value is fixed means it is called constant, okay children. For example, what is the distance between two parallel lines? You can measure anywhere, the distance is always same means constant, okay. For example, another example, the distance between two railway tracks, that means two parallel railway tracks, wherever you mention the distance is always constant, okay children. Understood? For example, take 100 rupees note. What is the value of 100 rupees note in Andhra Pradesh? 101. In Madhya Pradesh, 101. Wherever you go to India, the cost of the 100 rupees note will be 100 only. That means 100 is a constant. Okay children, one more example. How many days in a week? How many days children? 7 days. So 7 is a constant. Okay children, understood? Okay. Now, once again, remember the definition, constant. A symbol having a fixed numerical value is called a constant. Okay, that means all the numbers, digits are also constants. Okay children, very good. Next, variable. So variables also called literals. What is this definition? Look at the board all of you clearly. A symbol which takes on various numerical values is known as a variable or literals. Once again, a symbol which takes on various numerical values is known as a variable or literals. For example, perimeter of a square equal, what is the formula children? 4 into side. If side are denoted by small s, so 4 into side nothing but 4s. See here, what you are observing, 4 is constant, s is called variable. Because if you change the length of the side, the perimeter of the square also changes. Understood? So variable means which takes different numerical value. That means it considers different numerical values. For example, what is the temperature at morning? For example, 25 degrees or 20 degrees. What is the temperature at noon time? Maybe 30 or 35 degrees. What is the temperature at evening? Maybe rising or falling down. So temperature in a day, it is every time it will be changes, not fixed. So here temperature is called variable because its value will be changes. Are understanding? Okay children, one more example. Now, what is the height of a student at 5 years? What is the height of a student at 10 years? The height will be changed or not? Of course, some possibilities is there, some persons depend upon their physical activity, but general height will be, what happens children? Changes. So, the height is called variable. Understand clearly? Answer? Okay. So variable means what children? A quantity or a symbol which takes different numerical values is called variable. Okay children? Once again, look at the word variable. A symbol which takes on various numerical values is known as a variable or literals. For example, perimeter of a square equal to 4 into side or 4 into s. Here constant is what children? 4. What is the variable? S. Understood? Here one more thing remember. So variables generally we denoted by English alphabet. Okay. So that's why those are called literals also. Understood? Variables are denoted by English alphabet, generally small alphabet. For example, perimeter of rectangle formula, what? Perimeter of rectangle b equal to 2 into l plus b for rectangle. Rectangle perimeter of rectangle 2 into l plus b. Here l means length, b means breadth. Length and breadth changes means then automatically perimeter also changes. So those type of symbols are called variables. Understanding? Once again recall, what is the constant? A symbol having a fixed numerical value is called a constant. All the numbers are called constant, variable. A symbol which takes on various numerical values is known as a variables or literals. So perimeter of a solid, that means volumes we are using in mensuration, those are all comes under variables. Clear children? So variables generally denoted by English small alphabet, small a, b, c up to z. Are understanding? Next we go for next concept. So next fundamental concept, algebraic expression or algebraic expressions, plural form. What is this definition? A combination of constants and variables connected by plus, minus, into and divided by is known as an algebraic expression. Understood? A combination of constants and variables connected by 4 mathematical operations. What are the 4 mathematical operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Then that expression is called algebraic expression. Example say x plus y. Okay, x is a variable, y is another variable. So we are add together x plus y. You see, 2 into x directly. 2x means 2 into x. Okay. Twice of x is called 2x. Here 3 into x, that means 3x squared. Okay. Here 5 constant into variable plus constant into variable y minus constant into variable z. 5x plus 2y minus 3z. Those are all called algebraic expressions. Understood, children? So next definition. Tens. What are the meaning of tens? Several parts of an algebraic expression separated by plus or minus signs are called the terms of the expression. So example C. 6a plus 5b, it is an algebraic expression. The combination of the constant variables separated by plus, minus, into, divisions. Which operation is there? Plus. So 6a plus 5b is an algebraic expression. So what are the terms? So in one, 6a one term, 5b one term, because plus is separated the two terms. 6a plus 5b. Come to this example. Here what are the terms? X is one term, y is one term. Here entirely 2x is only one term. Here 3x square entirely only one term. Here how many terms? 3 terms. First 2 separated by plus, remaining last 2 separated by minus. So those are called terms. Once again, read along with me. Algebraic expressions. A combination of constant and variables connected by plus, minus, into and division is known as an algebraic expression. What are the terms? Several parts of an algebraic expression separated by plus or minus signs are called the terms of the expression. Okay, for example, take your name, keep each letter plus symbol. For example, your name Happy, H plus, A plus, P plus, P plus, Y. So Happy. So this total entire, your name Happy connected by plus symbol is called, what we call, remember, algebraic expression. Each letter H, A, P, P, Y are called terms. Understood? Okay, children? Okay. Next fundamental concept. Next we learn types of algebraic expressions. So after now what we learn? What is constant? What is variable? What is an algebraic expression? What are the terms? Four concepts. Next one, types of algebraic expressions. Okay, so here what are the types of algebraic expression we will learn? So first one, monomial. Mono means single. Okay, what is monomial? An algebraic expression containing one term only is called a monomial. So an algebraic expression containing one term only is called a monomial. It contains only one term. So all the English alphabet separated by commas. So each one is called a monomial. Here see 5x. 5 into x, entirely one term. 6x square, this is entirely one term. Minus 3xy, it is also one term. 2x also one term. These all are called monomials. Understood? Second thing, binomial. What is binomial? An algebraic expression containing two terms is called a binomial. Bi means two. Okay? An algebraic expression containing two terms is called binomial. See, 2x minus 3y. 2x one term, 3y one term. They are separated by minus. X plus 5y. X one term, 5y one term. They are separated by plus. P plus Q. P one term, Q one term, they are separated by plus. Either plus or minus, what are it mean? So this is called binomials. Understood? Once again, what are the monomials? An algebraic expression containing only one term is called monomial. What are the binomials? An algebraic expression containing two terms is called a binomial. Third one, trinomial. So, what is trinomial? Look at the board. Trinomials. Okay. An algebraic expression containing three terms is called a trinomial. An algebraic expression containing three terms is called a trinomial. Look here. A plus b minus c. Here, how many terms are there, children? Three terms. If see x plus 2a plus 3z. So, how many terms? Three terms. So, these two are exemplified trinomial. Once again, repeat it. An algebraic expression containing three terms is called a trinomial. Okay, children. Next, multinomials. An algebraic expression containing more than three terms is called a multinomial. Okay, an algebraic expression containing more than three terms is called a multinomial. Example, a square plus b square minus 2ab minus 4ac. Okay, children. So, this definition, some textbook also like this given. An algebraic expression containing two or more than two is also called multinomial. Understood? An algebraic expression containing two or more than two is also called multinomial. In special category, if it contains only two terms, is called binomial. Three terms is called trinomial. That's why the definition said as more than three. Understood? Okay. So four types learned. First one, what? Monomial. What is monomial? An algebraic expression containing only one term is called monomial. Second one, binomial. An algebraic expression containing two terms is called binomial. What is trinomial? An algebraic expression containing three terms is called trinomial. What is multinomial? An algebraic expression containing more than three terms is called multinomial. Or an algebraic expression containing two or more terms is also called multinomial. So this multinomial definition you remember carefully, because the same definition is coming under polynomials also. Okay, so multinomial. Okay, an algebraic expression containing more than three terms is called a multinomial. So those are the types of algebraic expressions. Understood? Okay. Next we see constant term. So what is a constant term? A term of the expression having no literal factor is called a constant term. For example, here x plus y minus 3. Here the constant term is minus 3. Minus 3 after no variable is there. So that's why minus 3 is called constant term. Understood? An algebraic expression containing only numbers, those are called constant terms. A constant, all the numbers are constant terms. Understood? So what is the factor? I not written here, but you know factor means what? If take any product, 3 into 4 equal 12. Okay? So what are the factors of 12? 3 and 4. Understood? So I think you know the definition of factor. So 6 2 is 12. What are the factors of 12 here? 6 and 2. So other factors also there. So factor means what? Any quantity divided by other quantity exactly. Okay? The divided quantity is called factor. Okay? So now come here. Coefficients. Any factor of a term is called the coefficient of the product of other factors. For example, minus 3 into x square into y. This is read as minus 3 into x square into y. Here 3 is one factor, x square is one factor, cohesion factor, because all are here product. Okay, all the quantities are multiplying, that's why each one is a factor. So especially minus 3 is called what? Numerical coefficient. Remaining x square is called what? Literal coefficient. Okay, so understand what is the coefficient. Any factor of a term is called a coefficient. If especially the factor is constant means numerical coefficient, otherwise literal means literal coefficients. Understood? Coefficient meaning, once again, any factor of a term is called the coefficient of the product of other factors. One more example, 6xy. In 6xy, what is the numerical coefficient? 6. What is the literal coefficient? xy. Are understood what is the coefficients? Okay, very good. So next we see like terms. Terms having same literal coefficients are called like terms. Otherwise they are called unlike terms. See this example, 7a square minus 3a square 2 by 3a square. So in this example, what you are understanding? A square common, observing a square, a square, a square. So literal coefficient, I mean literal factor is same, numerical factor is different. In 7 minus 3, 2 by 3. So these are called like terms. Otherwise, these are called unlike terms. For example, see unlike terms, x square, 3x square, minus 5x are unlike. Understood? X square, 3x square, minus 5x. See, here x square common, x of n, but here what? 5x, only x. So that's why they are called unlike terms. Of course, x square, 3x, these are like terms, but 3 are unlike terms. Understood? So today what we have discussed is fundamental concepts of algebra. Okay, once we revise, constant, what is a constant? A symbol or a quantity which have a fixed numerical value is called a constant. What is a variable? A symbol which takes numerical different values or which have no fixed value is called variable. What is an algebraic expression? An expression containing different terms separated by plus, minus, into and division is called algebraic expression. The terms separated by plus and minus are called terms. Okay. Next, coefficient. Coefficient means what? The factor of a term comparing with other terms is called coefficient. If coefficient is a number means numerical coefficient. If it is letter means literal coefficient. Next, like terms, unlike terms. What are the like terms? The literal coefficients are equal. Those are called like terms. Otherwise, unlike terms. So, you can watch the video, pause it, zoom in, and write it down on your running notebook. If you have any doubt, you can comment on through the mail or through the WhatsApp number. For more videos, you can please subscribe the channel. If you subscribe the channel, then automatically got the notification. For example, if your parents are today forget IIT class, if you click on the subscribe button on the channel, red color subscribe button is there. Click on that means whenever we upload the video, you can get the notification. Then you can easily watch the video. Understood? So thank you.